What's happening, guys? T-Slaps here, and we are back with Draft Baby. I'm your coach of the Austin FC for Deerlings in this inaugural season of Generation 9 Wi-Fi. This is a round 2 game of the UNPO playoffs, and at this point, it's still win or go home. We played well enough in the regular season, but we need to perform the best in the league these last few weeks to claim the champion title. We managed to squeeze out a very unconventional win last week, and this week we are expecting a full game to really challenge our place in playoffs. This week we are going up against One Crash of 94 and the Los Angeles Lucarios, who finished second in their division. Check out our opponent and all the other UNPL coaches down in the description below, as well as be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on our debut season of Generation 9 Wi-Fi, and leave a like if you do end up enjoying the content. I would really appreciate it. This is going to be the team builder section of the video, and on screen is a timestamp where you can go ahead and skip to see the battle. Now, our opponent has a very hyper-offensive team, with one of the newest additions to the game, Raging Bull. They also have Sand with Excadrone Tyranitar, Hazards in Hisuian Samurott and Tentacruel, and two very scary Terra Captains for our team to deal with in Hisuian Typhlosion and Galarian Articuno. If we want to advance to the semifinals this week, we are going to have to build the best team possible and play our absolute best, and I believe we do have the best team for our opponent. We're going to start off the team with our faithful Terra Captain, Orthworm. Physically defensive Orthworm does amazing at stopping Excadrill, Hisuian Samurott, and Scyther dead in their tracks. Thanks to the Earth Eater ability, we are immune to ground stabs from Excadrill, and with our held ability shield, we can even stay immune to Earthquake from a Moldbreaker Excadrill. We also can Terastalize into an Electric type, where we stay resistant to the Steel Stab while also shedding our weakness to fighting coverage, such as Brick Break Excadrill or Sacred Sword Hisuian Samurott. We can then hit back with a powerful Body Press. We carry Heavy Slam as Stab to hit the Sylveon Superior and the Galarian Articuno, and Earthquake as coverage for the Raging Bolt, Hisuian Typhlosion, or Tentacruel. We have Stealth Rocks on this set, as Hazard Ship could be very important late game, as their team also gets chipped down by Sand, and because their Hazard Removers in Excadrill and Tentacruel have trouble switching into my team to get that Rapid Spin off. One Pokemon that offensively pressures their Rapid Spinners is Infernape. We're opting for a 4 attacks extra belt set, which has super effective coverage for nearly the entire opposing team. Close combat as Stab breaks through Hisuian Samurott, Excadrill, and Tyranitar. Knockoff breaks Galarian Articuno and Hisuian Typhlosion while also removing important items off of other opposing Pokemon. Funk Shot breaks the Sylveon and Superior, and Mach Punch as priority can threaten a Dragon Dancing Tyranitar, a Sand Rush boosted Excadrill, or even out-prioritize Thunderclap Raging Bolt. We have enough speed to outpace max speed Scyther and threaten the entire opposing team extremely well anytime Infernape is on the field. For additional offensive power and a Pokemon that naturally outspeeds the entire opposing team, we have Darkrai. We're running a 4 attacks Darkrai this week with Dark Pulse as our main stab to break through anything that doesn't immediately resist the Dark typing, Sludge Bomb to break Sylveon, and Focus Blast to hit the Hisuian Samurott, Tyranitar, and Excadrill. For some secret tech, we have Throat Chop to prevent Sylveon from being able to use Hyper Voice or Alluring Voice and threaten our Darkrai. We're running a pretty bulky AV set in order to allow Darkrai to be a potential pivot into Hisuian Typhlosion or to better take a Thunderclap from Raging Bolt. Now, our opponent has a lot of hazard options to break down our team, with multiple Stealth Rockers, Toxic Spikes on Tentacruel, and Spikes on Hisuian Samurott. This week, we need to bring our staple Defogger Scizor. With the Heavy Duty Boots, we can switch in as often as we need to in order to remove hazards, which Scizor can do pretty freely on like Sylveon or Superior, as they lack coverage or Terra to hit Scizor. We're carrying Bullet Punch as our main stab in order to break Sylveon, or as to get priority in essential chip damage, or even threaten KOs on Pokemon attempting to sweep. Knockoff removes items and pressures Hisuian Typhlosion and Galarian Articuno prior to Terastalizing. And we also have U-Turn as our final move in order to break the Superior and allow my team to gain momentum on obvious pivots out of Scizor. For Pokemon such as Hisuian Typhlosion or Galarian Articuno that we would have to pivot out of Scizor on, we can switch to our specially defensive Clefable. We're opting for a Magic Guard set to avoid Hazard and Sandstorm chip from the opposing team, with Wish and Protect to keep Clefable and our entire team healthy. We have Moonblast as our main stab, which Pokemon such as Raging Bolt and Terra Fighting Galarian Articuno are going to be afraid of, with Encore in order to trap those Pokemon into Calm Mind setup or to prevent ourselves from being swept. Lastly, after sitting on the bench last week, we have the return of our Golden Wall Gastrodon. We're running a mixed wall this week in order to alleviate some specially defensive pressure off of Clefable so it can more freely stop setup sweepers and pass whizzes onto our team. We have enough physical defense to take on the Tyranitar, or we can take two knockoffs from Max Attack Adam and Set. We have Earthworm, we can easily sponge those hits. However, we don't want to risk taking a knockoff and losing our immunity to Earthquake from Moldbreaker Excadrill. We have Earthquake as our main stab, which pressures the opposing team extremely well and breaks past Calm Mind, Raging Bolt. Ice Beam to hit the Superior, Scyther, Hisuian Typhlosion after Terastalizing, or the Galarian Articuno prior to Terastalizing. Recovery will keep our Gastrodon healthy, with Yawn prevent setup spam and promote more Stealth Rock chip onto our opponent as they're forced to pivot out. This is our team for round 2, or the quarterfinals of the UNPL Academy playoffs. I'm so excited to see how this team works out and if we're able to make it alive and move to the semifinals in our first season of Generation 9 Wi-Fi. What do you think? What would you change? Let me know down in the comments below. Make sure you subscribe to not miss a single week of Draft League content. The playlist is in the description for the UNPL Academy and our other Wi-Fi league starting up, the BBRD League. Go check out our opponent as well in the description below. Thank you so much for sticking around for the team builder. Please leave a like if you did enjoy, and without holding y'all any longer, let's hop right into the battle. And we're hopping into this game against our opponent. Let's see what they decided to bring. I'm pretty scared. Gonna be a good match though, I hope. Hoping not to see... there's the Galarian Articuno. I was kind of hoping not to see that. But we see Hisuian Samurott. We see Galarian Zap. Or not Zap, Articuno. We see Excadrill. We see Hisuian Typhlosion. We see Tyranitar, and we see the Tentacruel. So, no Raging Bolt is actually crazy. No Raging Bolt's nice. No Sylveon's pretty nice. No Serp. No Scyther. Okay. Also, they brought both their Terra Captains, which I expected. Went over that in prep. Did expect that. What do I want to lead off with? Unfortunately, I don't really like leading with Infernape because I can't U-turn. Although Infernape does pick up the kill on anything, I think, that they decide to lead with. Worst case, they lead either his Samurott or... worst case, they lead Samurott, because I'd have to watch for Aqua Jet. Or like a Scarf, a Scarfer. I'm kind of okay with that. If they go Samurott, I guess we're alright. If they lead either one of those two, I have pivots out, not a big deal. And if we see like it's a Scarf Articuno, that's cool. Good look up onto our opponent. Let's see what they decide to do. If they are Terra the Typhlosion, I'm expecting Grass. They could also Terra into a Fire or a Stellar type. If they go with the Galarian Articuno, I'm expecting, if they're Scarfed, Flying. If they're set up, set Fighting. I don't think Terra Fire comes. So no Raging Bolt's really, really nice. That takes some pressure off of my Clefable. No Sylveon's nice, although that means I did kind of waste that fourth move slot on Darkrai. Superior is pretty nice, and no Scyther is actually really nice. But they're going to lead off with their thing here, their Tyranitar. If they're Tropple, do I kill? The chances are probably not. But I kind of want to just go for it anyways. I don't think you ever stay in here. I imagine you're Rock Set. I kill you always. If you're Choppleberry, I might just kill you anyways. It depends on your spread. I kind of want to knock. Knock means that I live any hit. And I can kill the following turn. It covers a pivot out. I kind of want to click knock, and I think that's a better play. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to go ahead and click knock. It covers anything. I won't get the defense drops. They're going to go ahead and swap out. So we're going to get a nice knockoff here onto Scarfy. What is that? That's a... Okay, it's going to be the... Gonna be the Tentacool, and we're gonna knock off a Black Sludge, which is really, really nice. I'm gonna kill with Earthquake here at this point. And we do still be outspeed it because of the Sandstorm chip. That's gonna be something really important to note. We can go ahead and just knock this thing out right now. Oh wait, I don't have Earthquake on this set. Oh, I don't. Oh yeah. I'm thinking about, I know I debated it for a long time with the Tentacool, but I decided Gunk Shot for the Sylveon, and now I'm regretting it. This sucks. I do actually not kill this thing. We did about 35% though, maybe 30. I forgot about the chip. I can go ahead and go into Scizor. Scizor's fine. It really doesn't do much for me. I guess it could help with the Articuno, but this is fine. I'm gonna go into my Scizor here. So knock off. It looks maybe a bit more physically defensive. I can go into my Scizor here. The flip turn. They're going to Toxic, which is fine with me. So they're sitting at about like 60%, maybe like 65. And we saw Toxic. So we can go ahead and U-turn out. That's pretty free. If they stay in, that's cool. I just wanted to get into here because, like I said, I don't really need health on Scizor too much because they didn't bring the Sylveon or the Superior. I guess it could be nice for the Galarian Articuno, but I get this slow U-turn off here, and I can pivot out from there. They're going to go ahead and click Knock. That's going to suck a little bit, but it's all right. I don't care about the boots. It's fine. Obviously, the thing isn't wanting to set T-Spikes, which is nice for me. And now I should be able to go into something that kills this, right? Darkrai, do you pick up the KO, bud? I really hope so. Not if you're Spideff. I could go into Gastro, but they could be carrying Giga Drain, Sludge Bomb for this. Man, not having an Earthquake on this actually sucks. I don't mind losing my Assault Vest, because, I mean, it could be nice to Typhlosion. I could go into Greg, but I don't want to risk a knockoff. Maybe staying in and knocking off again was my best bet. I'm going to go ahead and go into Darkrai. I think that's what I need to do here. I might have to take a knockoff, which is going to suck, but we can go ahead and go Darkrai. I didn't see what the U-turn chip left it at. That's why I couldn't really see. What are we looking at? Oh, yeah, we definitely killed the Dark Pulse at this range. I really want to Focus Blast predicting. There's not really a point in me doing it, though. We get quick Dark Pulse here. We do a good amount. We should be able to pick up this thing with KO. Did it occur with U-turn? Because I feel like I did a lot. I didn't see. I was writing things down. But the thing's sitting at about 30%. They're switching into this Dark Pulse. It's going to be T-Tar or the Hisuian Samurott. I'm definitely thinking Chopperberry in the back of my mind when it comes to either one of those Pokemon. This is definitely an interesting six. I didn't expect the Raging Bolt, but I think, honestly, they probably had a similar problem I had last week, where it was a lot of, wow, eight Mons fit really, really well into this team. What six do I ultimately want to go with? So they're going to go ahead, go into their Tyranitar. I honestly don't mind, I think, going into Scizor here rather than Gastrodon. Gastrodon was always my plan, but I think I can go Scizor here and just, like, get the Defog off right away. If this Tyranitar has Fire Punch, I imagine it gets Fire Punch, right? I'm like pretty sure it does. Yeah, it does. Maybe I do want to go Gastro. If I go Gastro, what is your play into an Earth Power? I guess Articuno. That's really about it. So I actually do pretty well. I'm going to go ahead. I can Defog later, I suppose. I don't know. I really want to go Scizor here and prevent these rocks. Oh, man. I mean, I don't need Scizor for a ton. I'm going to go ahead and go into it. Bullet Punch isn't super crucial against their team. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to go ahead and try to get these rocks off the field right away. What are we going to see from this thing? Thunder Wave. Okay, so now I really wish I went into Gastro now. But that's all right. That's all right. Also, what do the Sand Turns look like? I feel like it's been 5 turns at this point. So this Sand Stream. Or not Sandstream. Yeah, it's Smooth Rock. Okay, so not Chopple, it's Smooth Rock. Which means that is a, what is it called? That is probably a Sandrush Excadrill. No Mold Breaker. So Ability Shield looking a little bit tough. We'll have to double check that. I'm going to go ahead and click U-turn here. Get a free U-turn off. If they Fire Punch me, they Fire Punch me. Flamethrower. I should live this. I don't live it. Was that a crit? Wow, that dude just killed me. Okay. Flamethrower. And now I get to go back into Infernape and claim. So going to Infernape here. I get to click Close Combat. Wow. Okay, I should have predicted that. That was a bad play. Yeah. That was such a bad play. Because, yeah, that was bad. I don't know why I did that. T-Tar, Heal, Scizor. That was a bad play. I should have gone into Gastro. That's the whole reason why I brought it. So we're going to go ahead. We're going to kill the Tentacruel. Infernape kills Tentacruel. T-Tar sitting like at 95%. And they lost a spinner. I guess Excadrill could also have spin. That was a bad play with the Flamethrower. I knew that was coming in too. I knew it. And I didn't go into Gastro. So that was a bad play. Scissor could have been nice too. So they are going to see that we're Expert Belt. Now, does not kill this thing? Because it shouldn't be able to kill me with anything at this point. Knockoff should be able to pick up the KO. I guess it depends how much HP it has. It'd probably be running like a solid 100 or so. So I wouldn't be able to pick up the kill probably. But it doesn't kill me with anything, right? Like, what would... Oh, that's the wrong Typhlosion. What could you be running? Extra Sensory? I really just want to stay in and knock off here. I'm not going to lie. You kill me with Extra Sensory? I feel like I just stay in here and knock off. That's the wrong Pokemon. Infernape? Oh, I was looking at the wrong Pokemon. I was looking at Scissor with knockoff, so I actually wouldn't be able to pick the KO. I'm going to go ahead and go into Fae. See what they want to do. Yeah, knockoff actually wouldn't kill. At least not until the chip damage. The chip from the Sandstream is going to be really nice. We're going to see Eruption. So the Scarfed Eruption. Wow, okay. That'll be down to 191. Aw, man. My chip. It's going to knock me down to 191. So it did exactly 51 with Eruption. So, yeah, it's looking like just Timid Scarf. Good to know. Scarfed Eruption. Scarfed. So now I'm not afraid of it next time. Now I'm not afraid. So, at 215, can I live this? I should be able to. I can go ahead and fire off a Wish here and see what they want to do. I should live this. Yeah. So, definitely Timid. And that two eruptions used. So I get to protect here. Do I want to Moonblast, like predicting that or anything? Not really. I think protect is fine. Dang, I really misplayed on that Scizor. I really feel bad about that. That was not a good play, especially because my Earth Power right now looks really, really strong into their team, minus that Articuno. So you're definitely not Stellar type. You're either going to be Terra Fire. Terra Fire could have been bad there. Or Terra Grass. They're going to go into Articuno here. And that's fine with me. That is completely fine. If they set up, I have Encore. We pressure it out. And we just go. And we just do something else. So. I'm going to go ahead. I think I want to click Wish. And see what they do. I'm going to click Wish and see what they do. Yeah, they're Calm Mining. That's cool with me. I get to Encore you next turn. So, do you kill me at plus one with anything? Plus one. You shouldn't. Glaring. What is it called? Freezing Glare? Freezing Glare. Shouldn't kill me. I'm going to go ahead and click Encore here. And then, what is our play? Do we go... Oogie? Is Oogie our play and we can just Heavy Slam it? That could be nice. We would never pop a Weakness Policy. We could also go into Darkrai. Start Throat Chopping it. But if it tears into a Fighting type, we're in a bad spot. I think I like going Orthworm and clicking Heavy Slam after this. So I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go ahead, click Encore here, and then go into Orthworm. Okay, so they got me for the Encore. Good play. Calm Mine. So they're going to go back into their Tyranitar here. I mean, what are you going to do to me here? Set up your rocks? That'd be annoying. Especially because I don't have any way to remove them now. If I go Hard Ape and I CC, I'm not in a good spot. I really want to... I'm going to go into... Yeah, I'm going to go into Gastro, finally. I'm going to go into my Gastrodon, like I should have done before. I really need to find a position where I can get up my rocks. That's going to be really nice for the Tyranitar, chipping it down. The Typhlosion, because it's not rocks. Or not boots, I mean. Maybe the Galarian Zap. So they're going to set up the rocks with T-Tar. So I wonder what your final move is. Probably Knock or something. Or Dark Pulse. Because that Flamethrower did a lot. That was Rocks. Okay. So we get to fire off a crazy Earthquake here. Like, an insane Earthquake against their team. I suppose I could Ice Beam predicting the Galarian Articuno, but I'm not afraid of that. Knock is going to knock me down to 265, which is fine. We EV'd in order to take two of those. I'm going to EQ, do about half. I'm going to go ahead and fire off a recovery here. If they go into Galarian Articuno, I get to Yawn the following turn. So T-Tar's sitting at just below half. We're going to see the Galarian Articuno come back in. And that's cool with me. I want to Yawn here. I'm going to fire off a Yawn. Pivot out into probably my Earthworm to try to get rocks up. You're lefties. Okay. So you're not boots either. I really need to get my rocks up then. Leftovers. Okay, I'm going to Yawn here. And we're going to see what they do. Freezing Glare. How much are you doing to me? 307. Knocking me down to 307. We get the Yawn off. So, that knocked me down to 307 with Freezing Glare. So it did 28%. So that is what? Am I missing something here? Oh, you're still plus one. That is no special attack investment. Okay, so good to know. I get to just pivot out here. What do you go into? Hisuian Samurott? I think Earthworm is free here. Earthworm is super free. You pivot into Hisuian Samurott. I don't know what else you'd pivot into. Slash Kicks, yeah. Hisuian Samurott. And now I get to set up my rocks here. And I'm going to Terra set up my rocks. Sucks tarrying because now I'm going to take 12% from rocks instead of just 6. But I don't want to take a Sacred Sword to the face. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. We're going to Terra. I'm going to set up my rocks here. It's going to be super important. We're going to see what this thing wants to do to me. Let me see. Against the Hisuian Samurott. Let's just say, I don't know, Choice Scarf set. We're going to Terra into an Electric type. And you're going to Ceaseless Edge me. So man. Me losing my Scizor is going to cost me a ton this game. So, knock me down to 69. So, did 25% with a Ceaseless Edge. So, it's looking like just Max Attack Jolly. Oh, man. And I take Sandstorm shit now. Oh, we're not in a great spot. We are not in a great spot here. All right. We get the Body Press here for pretty much free, though. Your switch in is nothing. Oh. Your Articuno, that's a little annoying. Oh man, losing my Scizor is going to cost me. Not being able to defog this away. But my rocks being up is really, really nice. We're going to flip turn. Yeah, we are not looking great right now. Oh. So I got rocks and spikes up on my side. They have rocks. Alright, so we're going to kill the T-Tar, which is actually super good. How much turns of sand do they have left? They just lost their Sandstorm for the game. Okay. Worm kills T-Tar. I don't know what they were expecting there. I don't know. Okay. That's great for me. That is great. They are out of Sandstorm for the rest of the game. You go into this. You're going to take rocks. So Eruption actually does less now. You're going to see my ability shield. Maybe you aren't Moldbreaker. Okay, so it's good to keep Greg around. Oh, man. We are not looking great. Okay. So, let me see. A Choice Scarfed Assuming Typhlosion against my team. It's sitting at 76%. Clefable should just be able to take two of anything. I'm at full. Yeah. We're going to go into Clefable here. Worst case, you like Infernal Parade, I guess, and then you get the burn. Let's see. Let's see what they decide to do. They're going to Eruption here. It's not going to do a ton. I might be able to... I might have to let myself... Yeah, I'm cool with Clefable not getting a wish here. I think wish passing into my Earthworm is actually going to be really, really nice here. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to try to wish into my Earthworm. Getting Earthworm back up the decent health for the Excadrill in case it is Mold Breaker Rapid Spin is going to be really, really nice. We are going to see the Excadrill come in. Can we live a hit with Earthworm? I feel like we can, right? We also didn't see Mold Breaker. I don't think we saw Mold Breaker. Can I check? I don't think I saw it. I wasn't looking. I don't think it was. But if I go into Greg here, it doesn't matter, right? If I go into Greg here, can I take any hit from you? I'm at 147. 43. I should be able to take anything. I'm going to go into Earthworm here. I think we take anything. Brick Break. Oh, it's going to be close. It might kill me with a Brick Break here if he clicks it. Well, that's without Terra Electric. He's going to SD here. We should be fine. Going to SD here. I'm going to get my wish. And at plus two, we get rid of the rocks and the spikes. Stop giving me reflect. sitting at 259. It's a 3 KO with Brick Break. So I think we're fine just to body press here. They're going to rock slide me. Oh, I guess that's not something I thought about. Wow, you're kidding me. Okay. You click it again. Click it again. Don't flinch me. Dude! You're choking! Okay, you don't kill me with spin here, right? 62 HP? You can kill me with spin. What is my play now? Wow, you're joking me. Okay, I don't lose because I still have Infernape. So as long as I don't let it spin here, we're okay. But the thing is, how do I prevent it from spinning? You're joking me. You're joking. Infernape Mach Punch doesn't kill this thing. And I wish I had Sucker Punch now with Darkrai. Oh no. Gastrodon drops. There's no way for me to prevent a rapid spin here is the problem. I just have to hope they don't click it. Okay. That sucks. That is... Oh my gosh. I need to find out the odds of that. So Drill kills Worm. We get to go into Ape now because we know we outspeed and they didn't click Rapid Spin. And unfortunately, I don't have Fire Stab. Fire Stab would be really, really nice here to click. But we never risk this. We just can't. We have to click Close Combat here because you never kill it in Knock, right? We never kill it in Knock. I really want to predict it, yeah. But I just can't, dude. That was insane. That was the most pathetic thing I've ever seen. That was crazy. So, they're going to go into this. Can I just kill with a Knock at this point? Galarian Zapdos? Or Articuno? Their max HP. We're looking at... It's like at... I want to say that was max defense, if I'm being honest. I kind of just want to go into Gengar. Not Gengar, what is it called? Darkrai here. For max defense, I never killed this thing. Right, with leftovers. Yeah, it never killed this thing, it's max defense. So if I go into Darkrai here, it can't call my past me, right? I should never be able to. I'm going to go ahead and go into my dark right here. Wow, dude, I can't believe that happened. Two rock slides flinch shoes on top of landing two rock slides. I'm going to go into dark right here. Try to pressure this thing out immediately. What are we going to see? Oh my god, some spikes too. Recover? This thing gets recover? I expected roost. Okay. Did not know that. So Dark Bull should two-shot this thing no matter what. And it's pretty freaking 13. If they go Samurott, that's unfortunate. But I just can't risk it. We click Dark Pulse here. Can we kill Samurott Dark Pulse into Focus Blast? It's a roll. After Rocks, we should be able to, it looks like. Even if AV. We're going to go ahead and click Dark Pulse here. Oh, I forgot about Terra. Oh, I forgot about Terra. I forgot about Terra. Oh, no, 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 no. All right, we're in a bad spot now. We're in a terrible spot now. Can I get the flinch? They're going to Terra flying here. That's cool with me. They crit me! And now I can't switch back in. Oh, what is this? What is this? Oh. Okay. I think we just lose this game now. Yeah, I think we just lose this game. I could go for flinch. I could go for the flinch, and we might be able to two-shot it. We see Darkrai against a Terra flying set. We have a chance to... That's if it's not leftovers, though. So I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to have to pivot out. Is Gastrodon my play here? I feel like it is. I feel like it is. I think I'll go Clef. I'm gonna go Clef. Wow, that is awful. I die to Hazard now because of the crit. I should have had Orthworm still alive at least. I wouldn't have gotten Rock Slide flinch. They're gonna Terra Blast me again, so I should have just Dark Pulsed. No, we're fine. We're fine. I think that was the right play. We ate that. Oh man, I can't believe that just happened. Okay, so we just get the wish up here. I mean, the problem is Excadrill comes in again, right? So do I want to pivot out on Drill coming in and go into Caesar? I really do. If I don't make that play, then what happens? I can always sack Darkrai so they don't get to spin off and I get to go back into Ape. I really wish I had Fire Stab at this point. I really wish I had Fire Stab. That or I go into, I guess, Gastrodon. Gastrodon, I think, can limit hit. I'm gonna go ahead and throw up the wish here. I'm gonna throw up a wish. I should be fine with my Darkrai sack. We're in such a bad spot. They're gonna freeze and glare me here. I think I live this. I guess they're going for freeze. I mean, might as well. You have all the hacks in the game anyways. So, I have to protect here in case they click, in case they click Terra Blast, because they'd kill me at this point. Luckily, when they come in, they do have to take rocks again. So, I think a combination of both of those, of rocks, gunk, plus the knockoff might be enough to kill. Probably not with an Infernape. Oh, Darkrai, yeah. Darkrai should be able to at least chip it down for Infernape. Hisuian Samurott, I have to be scared of, because if it has Aqua Jet, I also kind of lose to that. Wait, Darkrai can never chip this thing down because of... Ah, damn it. Okay, we have to protect here. Unfortunately, that invites in Drill. But they aren't going to go into it. I feel like they click Calm Mind here. Yeah, free. I click Wish this time around, because I feel like you just don't click what I want you to click. You don't click Calm Mind now, knowing I'm going to Encore. So I click Wish here. And then I just kind of sit here and lose to this thing. I'm not going to lie. I'm in a bad spot because of this. I'm in a bad spot because of the crit, because of everything. because of the rock slide flint shoes and everything. So I'm gonna go ahead and click Wish here, because you definitely just click Freezing Glare, or you click Terra Blast. Yeah, you click Terra Blast. So are we looking at 3 Terra Blasts? 4? We might have to PP Terra Blast out at this point. We're gonna fire off a Wish. I can live one. So do I Encore on the Calm Mind here? I should live one. Let me see. Terra Blast. I should live one against, let me see, my Clefable here. At plus one. I'm sitting at 178. It's a rule most definitely in their favor. It's like a 50-50. That's not something I'm willing to want to risk. It's something I have to risk, though. I think I have to risk it here. I'm in a bad spot because of everything in this game. I'm going to go ahead and click Encore. Oh, man. That sucks. That's game. Yeah. That's game. Got completely terribly hexed out. I go into Gastro. Quick Yawn. Try to force this thing out. Do I even live a hit with Gastro? That was the thing. I do. I should. I get the Quickie on here. And then we're in an okay spot. Did my recording cut out? Oh, my thing crashed. What the heck? My software. My recording software. So we are going to leave the hit, by the way. I'm trying to load it back up right now. We okay? Are we back on? Let me see. So I lived the hit. I got the Yawn off. That's weird that it cut out like that. That sucks. Even no recording devices were found. Come back on. Are we there yet? I can't even see my monitor anymore, my TV screen. I think we're back up. No, we are not. Okay. That kind of sucks. I might have to borrow my opponent's footage here. I have to make a move here, though. I'm going to go ahead and click... What do you think? I guess recover. See if I can stay alive. Let me see if I can get this to work. They're just going to Terra Blast me. They are going to let their Galarian thing go down. I guess I could have gone into... Or they're going to let it go to sleep. I guess I could have gone into my Dark right here. That's fine. Okay. Still not going to work. That's fine. That's fine, though. I'm just going to keep recording my audio. So, and I'll just use my opponent's footage of the game. I'm going to go ahead and go into my 8 because that's all I can do at this point. This Galarian Articuno is luckily asleep now. So if I go ahead and go into this. Man, I wish I had my Fire Stab now. Fire Stab would have saved me this game too. All I can really do is click Knock Off and then Gunk a bunch. Hope I crit or something. So I'm going to go ahead and try to do that. So we don't get the crit here. That's fine, though. I'm going to go ahead and bar off some gunk shots. Hope for the best. Fire Stab would have been great. Can we get a crit? No crit. Can we get a crit this time? Or we need max sleep turns. But even if we do that, we just don't win the game because Typhlosion outspeeds us and kills us. Yeah, sucks. That's going to be the game, it seems like. I guess GG to our opponent. It really sucks that we lost that way. But that is going to be the end of our run. You can go check out the UNPO playlist down in the description below. You can go see how this entire season ended up to this point where we unfortunately got through some tough stuff. And soon we should be starting up the BBR D-League. I think this is going to go up on Friday. So on Sunday, I believe, we should have the draft analysis and the BBR to continue. So if you guys want more Draft League content, make sure to subscribe, of course. Like the video if you did enjoy. There'll probably be about one or two more UNPL videos going up after this. Obviously not playoff games, but other things relating to UNPL that I want to kind of put together. But other than that, yeah, Hacks kind of sucks. Of course, I did not give myself a good... I really put myself in a bad position to start with the scissor going down to Flamethrower. But I mean, we still had a great chance of winning that game. And getting double Rock Slide flinched, losing our Orthworm, which definitely pressured the Galarian Articuno a bunch. You know, it really sucked. But what can you do? That's the game we play. Once again, go check out our opponent. All the other UNPL coaches down in the description below. This has been Tony, aka T-Slaps, and I'm out.